Hard to believe, but 15 years ago, Nicholas Hoult shot to stardom as a gawky 12-year-old young man who attaches himself to Hugh Grant in the hit film About a Boy.
Well, it's safe to say he's grown out of his awkward stage, starring in the British hit show Skins and the epic X-Men film franchise.
Now Nicholas is taking on one of his biggest roles yet, starring as the legendary writer J.D. Salinger in the new movie Rebel in the Rye. Nicholas, good morning.
Hello. Good morning.
Welcome.
How are you guys? Thank you for having me.
So you guys were just talking about how long ago?
Yeah, 15 years.
Aging me big time. I can't believe it. 15 years.
Has it gone by pretty quickly for you?
Yeah, it's flown by. And now here I am, very happy.
Was it weird becoming famous at such a young age?
Yes and no. It was like an odd transition at times, but not really. Like, I still stayed at school, like a normal school, till I was 17. And kind of, it was like living a double life. I was like Bruce Wayne. It was like I'd occasionally go off and shoot a film and do this, and then I'd go back to school and it'd be very normal. Yeah.
I must say, Warm Bodies is one of my favorite zombie movies ever.
Thank you.
Absolutely loved you in that movie. If you haven't seen it, he's a zombie, falls in love with a girl, and it's a love story.
Yeah, it's like a classic Romeo and Juliet kind of story, but with a zombie twist. Yeah, exactly. So I like didn't have many lines to learn for that movie.
Yeah.
I just grunted.
Well, in this movie, you're playing, I mean, this iconic person in American literature, J.D. Salinger. Was that a little intimidating?
So intimidating. And the more I learned about him, the more, you know, I felt like I really needed to do the man justice. And it was an incredible script that Danny Strong wrote, and he had just such an intense but remarkable life, and how he came to create his masterpieces is such an incredible story that it was just a great one to tell, and something that hopefully people will love to see.
And there's not a lot of video of him as a person, so how do you beat someone when you can't really see how they were?
Yeah, it's interesting. It's not like doing an impression, even though obviously he was a real person. You're not trying to imitate a speech pattern or anything like that. So you kind of look where they grew up and try and develop an accent around that. And then I read a lot of his, you know, his novels alongside reading biographies, and then kind of pieced those together and then tried to capture the essence of the man and what he stood for. And he was just so unrelenting in his quest for truth and dedicated to his art. It's really inspiring.
Do you think some of that came from his experiences in the war and World War II, that he just didn't have tolerance for people's BS?
Completely. No, completely. He suffered PTSD after the war, and that was a huge part of his writing, and it goes into it. So, you know, all those things were parts of his life that I knew nothing about before reading the script and then researching the film. So it was very interesting to learn about.
We actually have a picture of you on the set of Mad Max.
Oh, yeah?
Knitting. Is that what you like to do?
You know what? I did on that movie. That was my thing in between setups on that movie. I knitted. I kind of pick up different hobbies depending on the movie. On Rebel in the Rye, we did 3-minute art, where we, Stacey and I, the makeup artist on the movie, we would find famous pieces of art and have 3 minutes with crayons to try and recreate them.
Really? Are you an artist?
No.
At all?
No, that's horrendous. When Sarah Paulson came in, she walked into the makeup trailer and there's all these like crayon drawings around, and she was looking around and she was so confused. She was like, I thought someone was an overproud parent of their kids' terrible drawings. And then she found out it was like all us adults at lunchtime doing that.
That's great. Well, Nicholas, the movie's terrific. Thank you so much for being here. Rebel in the Rye, in theaters this Friday. Hello, Today fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking that button down there and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives.